viewers, welcome to the lecture series on tourism. As we know, management is essentially the art of getting things done through and with the people. The managers, therefore, have the responsibility not only of planning and organizing the operations, but also in guiding and directing their subordinates. Direction is actually a continuing function of managers. It is a managerial function performed by all managers at all levels of the organization. For your easy understanding, this episode is divided into the following subheadings: meaning of direction, coordination, principles of effective coordination, supervision, functions of supervision. Let us start with the meaning of direction. In managerial field, direction is a complex function that includes all those activities which are designed to encourage subordinates to work effectively and efficiently in both the short and long run. In simple words, direction is the guiding subordinates in doing work. Definition of direction. Newman and Warren have defined direction as activation that deals with the steps a manager takes to get subordinates and others to carry out plans. A much more elaborative definition was given by Dale Yoder. According to him, direction is telling people what to do and seeing that they do it to the best of their ability. It is through directing that managers get the work done through people. Directing consists of issuing orders and instructions by a superior to his subordinates, guiding, advising and helping subordinates in the proper methods of work, motivating them to achieve goals by providing incentives, good working conditions, etc., supervising subordinates to ensure compliance with plans. Essential elements in directing. Directing involves majorly four elements. They are, number one, supervision. Supervision refers to the direct and immediate guidance and control of subordinates in the performance of their work. In order to see that the work is done according to the instructions, the superior must observe the activities of the subordinates. Supervision is done at all levels of management. However, it is more important at lower levels. Number two is the motivation. Motivation is another important element in directing. It is one of the most challenging problems for management. Management has to induce the employee to utilize his talent and skills to contribute his best in the achievement of organizational goals. Number three is the leadership. Leadership is an interpersonal process of influencing the behavior of individuals and groups so that they can accomplish the objectives with more efficiency and effectiveness. Number four is the communication. Communication is another most important aspect of managerial functions. Communication is the exchange of thoughts, facts, opinions, and information by two or more persons. Superiors can direct the performance of the subordinates by communicating the organizational goals to them. You will study each of the above elements in detail in the coming episodes. Coordination. In every organization, different types of work are performed by different individuals and groups, and no single group can be expected to achieve the goals of the organization as a whole. Hence, it becomes essential that the activities of different work groups and departments should be harmonized. This function of management is known as coordination. It ensures unity of action among individuals, work groups, and departments and brings harmony in carrying out the different activities and functions so as to achieve the organizational goals efficiently. In other words, coordination is the orderly arrangement of individual and group efforts to provide unity of action in the pursuit of a common goal. In an organization, for example, the purchase department buys raw materials for production. The production department produces the goods by using the raw materials, and the marketing department procures orders and sells the products. All these departments must function in an integrated manner so that the organizational goal is duly achieved. Thus, coordination involves synchronization of different activities and efforts of the various units of an organization so that the planned objective may be achieved with minimum conflict. Definition of coordination. According to EFL Bridge, coordination is balancing and keeping together the team by ensuring suitable allocation of tasks to the various members and seeing that the tasks are performed with the harmony among the members themselves. Importance of coordination. The need and importance of coordination can be judged from these points. Coordination encourages team spirit. There may exist conflicts between individuals, departments, between a line and staff, etc. Similarly, conflicts are also between individual objectives and organizational objectives. Coordination arranges the work and the objectives in such a way that there are minimum conflicts and rivalries. It encourages the employees to work as a team and achieve the common objectives of the organization. This increases the team spirit of the employees. Coordination gives proper direction. There are many departments in an organization. Each department performs different tasks. Coordination integrates, that is, bring together these activities for achieving the common goals or objectives of the organization. Thus, coordination gives proper direction to all the departments of the organization. Coordination facilitates motivation. Coordination gives complete freedom to the employees. It encourages the employees to show initiative. It also gives them many financial and non-financial incentives. Therefore, the employees get job satisfaction and they are motivated to perform better. Coordination makes optimum utilization of resources. Coordination helps to bring together the human and material resources of the organization. It helps to make optimum utilization of resources. These resources are used to achieve the objective of the organization. Coordination also minimizes the wastage of resources in the organization. Coordination helps to achieve the objectives quickly. Coordination helps to minimize the conflicts, wastages, delays, and other organizational problems. It ensures smooth working of the organization. Therefore, with the help of coordination, an organization can achieve its objectives easily and quickly. Coordination improves relations in the organization. The top level managers coordinate the activities of the middle level managers and develop good relations with them. Similarly, the middle level managers coordinate the activities of the lower level managers and develop good relations with them. Also, the lower level managers coordinates the activities of the workers and develop good relations with them. Thus, coordination improves the relations in the organization. Coordination leads to higher efficiency. Efficiency is the relationship between returns and cost. There will be higher efficiency when the returns are more and the cost is less. Since coordination leads to optimum utilization of resources, it results in more returns and low cost. Thus, coordination leads to higher efficiency. Coordination improves goodwill of the organization. Coordination helps an organization to sell high quality goods and services at reasonable prices. This improves the goodwill of the organization and helps it earn a good name and image in the market and corporate world. Principles of effective coordination. Various management researchers gave their own numbers with respect to the principles of coordination. Mary Parker Follett gave major four principles, and other modern management thinkers added some more principles of coordination. Altogether, let us group and study them as eight principles of coordination. The first principle is the principle of early stage. According to this principle, coordination must start at an early stage in the management process. It must start during the planning stage. This will result in making the best plans and implementing these plans with success. If coordination is started early, only then all the management functions will be performed successfully. Thus, by initiating proper coordination, the organization will achieve all its objectives easily and quickly. principles of continuity. According to this principle, coordination must be a continuous process. It must not be a one-time activity. The process of coordination must begin when the organization starts, and it must continue until the organization exists. Coordination must be done continuously during the management process. It must be done during planning, organizing, directing, and controlling. Principle of direct contact. According to this principle, all managers must have a direct contact with their subordinates. This will result in good relations between the manager and their subordinates. This is because direct contact helps to avoid misunderstandings, misinterpretations, and disputes between managers and subordinates. It enables the managers to coordinate all the different activities of their subordinates effectively and efficiently. Principle of reciprocal relations. The decisions and actions of all the people, that is, of all managers and employees and departments of the organization, are interrelated. So, the decisions and actions of one person or department will affect all other persons and departments in the organization. Therefore, before taking any decision or action, all managers must first find out the effect of that decision or action on the other persons and departments in the organization. This is called the principle of reciprocal relations. Coordination will be successful only if this principle is followed properly. Principle of effective communication. Coordination will be successful only in the presence of an effective communication. Good communication must be present between all departments, within employees themselves, and even between managers and their subordinates. All communication barriers and gaps must be avoided and fixed. Good communication helps to avoid misunderstanding in the organization. This overall helps in coordination. Principle of mutual respect. Coordination will be successful only if there exists a mutual respect throughout the organization. All managers working at different levels, top, middle, or lower, must respect each other. Similarly, all employees must show a friendly attitude and should respect each other during interactions. There must also exist a feeling of brotherhood among managers and employees. The managers must respect the feelings and emotions of the employees. On the other hand, employees too must understand and acknowledge their bosses. Without mutual respect, coordination may not survive and it will be eventually fail. Principle of clarity of objectives. Coordination will be successful only if the organization has set its clear objectives. Everyone in the organization must know the objectives very clearly. No one must have any doubts about the objectives of the organization. Clear objectives can be achieved easily and quickly. Principle of scalar chain. Scalar chain principle defined as the chain of supervisors ranging from the ultimate authority to the lowest rank. An employee should feel free to contact his superior about anything through the scalar chain. Every order, message, request, instruction, or explanation has to pass through the scalar chain. This part shows a company's line of authority and links through which communications are transmitted from the top to the bottom of the company and back, so that effective coordination among the members of the organization will be possible. Supervision. Supervision means overseeing the subordinates at work. All managers at whatever level perform a supervisory function. Supervision denotes the functions performed by the supervisors. While supervising, a manager draws his attention to the day-to-day work of employees and the interrelationship among them and the groups in the organization. Of all, the first line supervisors play a crucial role in controlling the blue-collar workforce in the enterprise. A supervisor is an effective link between workers and management. A supervisor is directly responsible for getting the work done by blue collar workers, and hence he has to be careful in discharging his functions of giving orders, instructions, laying down methods and procedures, and guiding his subordinates. Definitions of supervision. Terry and Franklin defined supervision as guiding and directing efforts of employees and other resources to accomplish stated work outputs. In the words of Newman and Warren, supervision is the day-to-day relationship between an executive and his immediate assistant and covers training, direction, motivation, coordination, maintenance of discipline, etc. Role of supervisors. If the supervisory force does not function effectively, organization cannot survive for long. According to Fred Luthans and Martinko, a supervisor must perform three kinds of roles, namely scientific management roles, human relation roles, and functional roles. Scientific management role. Scientific management role includes the role of a technician, analyst, and controller. The supervisor must first fully equip himself with the technical knowledge in order to supervise his subordinates. The supervisor must design the new and scientific procedures and methods to achieve efficiency in work operations. He should also exercise proper control of the operations in order to ensure that actual performance meet the pre-established standards. Human relation roles. According to human relations role, the supervisor should be sensitive and listen to the needs and desires of employees. Here, he should act as a counselor by rendering the advice to the employees concerning work-related problems so that productivity at work does not suffer. He acts as a motivator in the sense that he inspires the employees by providing congenial working conditions, tangible and intangible incentives for higher productivity. Further, a supervisor should act as a bridge between management and employees. He communicates the wishes of the top management to the workers, and at the same time, he represents the workers' demand and wishes to the top management. Functional roles. The functional roles of a supervisor include planning, organizing, leading, and controlling at the operational level. As a planner, the supervisor has the major responsibility of determining what exactly is to be done by the workers and communicate these goals to the workers. In the role of organizing, he should bring together and utilize the resources in most efficient manner. Finally, a supervisor is entrusted with the task of controlling the operations in the department or the unit. Functions of supervisors. Every manager, in the capacity of a supervisor, performs the following functions. Communicating the orders. The first duty of every supervisor is to communicate the orders to subordinates. In the absence of specific instructions or orders, there will be a chaos and confusion resulting in hampering of work. Subordinates would not be able to identify what is to be done and not to be done. The orders should be simple, complete, and in a language easily understandable to the subordinates. Introduction of new methods of performing work. Every supervisor should examine the existing methods of work and try his level best to improve the methods of performing work. In order to increase the productivity per worker, he should keep himself updated of the latest techniques and make the subordinates aware of such techniques. While introducing new methods, workers may resist. In that time, the supervisor is expected to overcome the resistance by creating awareness about the new techniques among the subordinates. Make the work interesting. A subordinate would feel like working only when he is comfortable at work. This is possible only when worker is placed on the job in which he is interested, qualified, the best suited to work. A supervisor should see whether employees are deriving job satisfaction. When he notices job dissatisfaction among the workers, he should probe deep into the causes contributing to such dissatisfaction. By removing the causes of dissatisfaction, he can make the work interesting. selecting the workers. In small and medium sized organizations, supervisor plays crucial role in selecting the workers. A supervisor should outline the job satisfaction and job descriptions so that right people are selected for the right places and at the right time. But of course, in bigger organizations, human resource department undertakes the responsibility of recruiting and selecting people required for the enterprise from time to time. Induction of new employees. Induction is very important to make the new employee familiar with the organization, work, peers, superiors, etc. By induction, a supervisor will be able to brief the new employee regarding his immediate and ultimate superiors, overall responsibilities of the section or department to which the new employee will be sent, working hours, his duties and responsibilities, remuneration and other monetary and non-monetary facilities, leaves, rules and details, etc. Training the employees. A supervisor must hold training sessions to update the technical knowledge of his subordinates. He should inspect workers' performance during the training period and suggest ways to improve it. From time to time, the supervisor should ascertain feedback whether the workers have learnt what was taught to them. After successful completing of training, employees would be in a position to increase the productivity. Handling grievances. Grievance handling and redress itself is a complicated procedure, no doubt, but the supervisor should attend to them at the grassroots level, if possible. He should be able to distinguish between the genuine grievances and silly complaints. If he encourages non-genuine complaints of all the employees, the result would be tremendous loss to the management. Enforcing discipline. One of the obligatory duties of a supervisor is to maintain discipline among the employees in the organization. Indiscipline among the employees may be caused due to the reasons such as low wages, low possibilities of career advancement, ill healthy human relations, bias of top management, poor working conditions, etc. The supervisor should analyze the cause of indiscipline and try to remove them if possible. If necessary, he can bring the causes of indiscipline to the top management for appropriate action. Effective communication. A supervisor should have good communication skills. A supervisor should see that the channels of communication are effective. The flow of communication should be smooth, quick, and uninterrupted. In organizations, a distorted message can create misunderstandings, conflicts, and problems. Enforcing safety. A supervisor is generally concerned with workers who actually perform the job and hence should show great concern to the employees' physical and mental safety. This is possible by providing them safety training. Organizations should educate the workers to follow safety rules. To sum up, directing is the process of guiding the subordinates in doing work. Directing has four essential elements: supervision, motivation, leadership, and communication. Coordination is the harmonization of activities of different groups and departments in achievement of organizational goals effectively. Coordination encourages team spirits, gives proper direction, motivates, helps in utilization of resources efficiently. It helps to achieve objectives quickly and improves organizational relationships. Supervision means overseeing the subordinates and their work. All managers supervise their immediate subordinates by monitoring their day-to-day work and performance. A supervisor plays scientific management role, human relations role, functional roles. A supervisor performs the functions such as communicating the orders, introduction of new methods, make the work interesting, selecting the workers, their training and induction, handling grievances, enforcing discipline and safety. I hope by going through this episode, you have successfully learned about the important aspects of directing and supervision. Hoping to continue our discussions in the coming episodes. Thank you.